concrete information. It's a lot of speculation. With the love story article, to make it Bolton specific, you could find a couple who's been dating all 4 years or something. Is that what you were going to say?
Yeah, like
high school sweetheart. Yeah, you know, something smushy like that. Find somebody and talk about their first date and how they met, you know, all that kind of stuff. People love that kind of stuff.
But you're kind of limited by that, because then what if they break up before the February issue?
Well, then that's their fault.
The pitching is where Molly gets to practice her leadership skills, and she asks us what we want to write about. We throw out ideas. Sometimes we take other people's ideas that they've thrown out that are extras, and we find out what we want to write about and the direction we're taking and ideas for pictures and things like that.
And they have to have a picture idea. They have to be able to back up. They can't just say field trips. I mean, they have to be able to tell me what the focus is, how they're going to make an article about field trips work. If they seem like they're passionate about it, if they seem like they're interested enough to write a good article, we go with it, and that's their assignment.
And then add some quotes in from a student.
We go around, everybody does that, and I pitch my ideas, and Mr. Robinson will step in occasionally if he feels like an article needs to be redirected or if somebody's proposed something that's just not going to work. And he'll step in and say something, but it's pretty much just the staff talking. It's great. Check in with us, I guess, on Wednesday or Thursday, and let us know, because if you need more time, this is a big thing, and we can give you another few days.
And bring what you have on, yes. Definitely bring what you have on Thursday.
Okay, have some started. Barlow's, you know, who runs it, you know, and how much of their sales come from Bolton students? Because I know there are always kids over there when they're not supposed to be.
It was a great article. It was about this gas station across the street that attracts a lot of students after school and before school.
I start with an idea. How much of your business would you say comes from Bolton students? And that idea has to be sort of narrowed down, and you have to pare it down.
Would you say the majority of your business does come from affiliation of the school?
Yeah, the teachers.
Teachers. And the foot traffic. And the
right, definitely.
Yeah.
Okay. After that, I sort of sit down and think about who I'll need to interview to get the information that I need, because it's about the information. That's the core.
I don't know what that means. But
well, no, you weren't.
We got some questions answered.
Did you get you got some questions?
He seemed
you got
really
some answers.
Fake. He didn't seem like he was being real. He said they ID everybody for everything.
No, you
only
have to have
ID.
ID for everything.
Have to have ID. Not just the school. Everybody.
Everybody.
You have to have ID.
All right.
And they tell you about. They ask you about how much business has come from students.
We asked them, and they said
probably around 30-40%.
30-40%.
You say the majority.
But from teachers and people coming during the day, and just from the people being over there more.
Journalism class at Bolton High School has taken on a new twist for this year. The student body, the seniors that have been involved, and some of the juniors and the writings that I've read have been journalistically correct or accurate, and they're going at it in a way that may be a little bit controversial, but at the same time, it's educational for those kids.
Do you think the world's going to end this year?
No, not this year.
My article is about the apocalypse. You know, it's 2012, we're all gonna die. Pshoom, there's the Earth on December 21st. Everyone's flipping out about it, or not flipping out about it, as the case may be. So I wanted to write an article, you know, what is the 2012 hubbub really about? What do the students think about? And, you know, just all that kind of stuff. All right, if you knew that you were gonna die this year, what all would you do?
Oh my God.
One of my favorite answers, I didn't get to put it in my article, but was, if the world was going to end, I would.
I sleep like 100 women.
I must smoke.
Like every type of weed out there.
And then I'm gonna give my life to Jesus.
Wait,
are you recording it? Is he recording it?
I believe so.
I don't know.
But interviews are always fun. You get to meet new people and get crazy answers like that.
So my first one was about the counselors. Like, you know, because we have them and they help us so much, they basically help us through school. Like, we talk to them if we need them, or, like, you know, if you need to, like, change your schedule at all, then, like, you just go in and talk to them kind of thing.
Do students ever show appreciation towards you, like, for what you do? Do you ever feel unappreciated? When they walk the carpet, or down the carpet during graduation, how do you feel?
But, like, we don't really ever, like, recognize how much they do for us, and so, like, you know, we could I could do something with that, just like talking to like the counselors, like about like how much time and effort they put into us, and then like just to have like some kids just like throw it away or like.
Print Edition starts with us making ideas or coming up with ideas and assigning an idea for an article to each student. We all write on that article. We write on that topic.
That's a good title.
It gets reviewed by our peers. It gets reviewed by Mr. Robinson.
Give it to me in the very beginning how it works. Okay?
He helps us with ideas. He helps us formulate those ideas. And then it gets dropped on the server, and myself, Zach, and Molly do the design work and put it all on the print edition.
My page number?
Page number, and leave room at the top for a little, like,
what are you putting?
Bar thing with a title.
Right there?
Yeah.
So once proofread, spell checked, all the good stuff has been looked over, we export it.
And it ends with those pages getting proofed and then sending it off to the printer. And then it comes back and we distribute it.
How we distribute, it's pretty helter-skelter. But we, well, we get the boxes, we rip them open, we're all excited. It's like Christmas. It's really Christmas when we open those boxes and can finally put our hands on what we've been working on. And, you know, that feels good, having people read your papers and, you know, walking around and seeing people reading it and talking about it. That's always really exciting. And it makes you feel like you're making a difference. And I think that's what a lot of this is about. It's about making a difference.